Ideas and liquor flow. Voila, we have the cabaret. simply means porte liqueur, a tray of drinks. Or sometimes the meaning came from, they thought, from 13th century Picardy, from the word cambarete, which was the diminutive of cambrai, and then chamber or room. In 1880, in Paris, in France really, there was huge technological change. Electricity came. The first cinema was introduced into Paris. They just had the Franco-Prussian War where the French were humiliated by the Prussians. There was a great divide between the rich and the poor, and there was a great conflict between the ruling established elite and the emerging bohemian struggling artists. There was a freedom of press, and the censorship laws were relaxed. Consequently, there was a gathering of artists and musicians and poets and philosophers. They called themselves les hydropathes. And they gathered together in these smoke-filled taverns to exchange ideas and sit around and watch people perform amateur skits and sarcastic plays about lampooning bourgeois conventions. These taverns, these cabarets, were popular with painters like Aristide Bruant or Toulouse-Lautrec, whose paintings profiled the destitute and the poor and the marginalized in France and in Paris especially. There was musicians who came and they amalgamated and blended the classical and the popular styles. And what is interesting is that many people got their start in the cabaret. For instance, Eric Satie composed for the cabaret. Claude Debussy played the piano and conducted the orchestra in the first cabaret. And Darius Milhaud played in the piano in the cabaret. So they were very popular places to meet. And actually, classical composers like Poulenc were so impressed with the cabaret that they wrote cabaret-style songs, not to be performed necessarily in the cabarets, but more in the formal concert halls. The first cabaret that we know of in Paris was Le Chat Noir. It was established by the impresario Rodolphe Sali. And in this cabaret, painters, poets, musicians were always welcome, but priests and military figures were banned. Le Chat Noir also means, in French, disobedient. And that's quite in tune with some of the radical ideas that were floating around the cabaret at that time. And I mentioned before Les Hydropathes. They were a group that helped found the first cabaret, but also they were adverse to anything to do with water. So cabaret, water was banned. They only were allowed to serve liquor and beer and wine. And the Les Hydropathes, because they were adverse to water, they didn't even bathe. So I guess at the first cabaret, they probably had their own table quite a ways removed from everyone else. So a toast to Les Hydropathes, and I'll hold my nose when I do it.